dear student, welcome back to the class. In previous class, we have discussed about My Hobbies. It is a beautiful poem about speaker, how he spent his time. Yes, what is the hobby of speaker? The speaker hobby is sketching. What he sketch? He sketch the beautiness of world. Yes, he enjoying the beautiness of world. Okay, dear student, how is the world in previous class? Yes, in previous class we described the world is very peaceful and serene. Okay, dear friend, let us start the new story. Unit 5, Hobbies. It is a additional story in 5th lesson, Good Hobbies. Okay, Good Hobbies. That means Valiya Havyasa. Yes. First, I read the story. You listen carefully. How I pronounced the word Good Hobbies. The unit group for Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu. He was born on November 7, 1888. He was very clever and smart. He was good in his studies and had good hobbies too. He loved to swim in the village pond for hours. He had so many friends to play with. They loved flying kites. They used to make colorful cats. The boy was always busy. When he had no work, he used to go for a long walk. He loved to watch the beauty of nature. He was very curious about everything around him. The boy waited for uni every day because it was time to listen to stories from his father. Many village people used to come to his father to listen to the stories of the Ramayana, the Mahabharata and the other stories. The father also used to play on the veena and violin. The boy enjoyed the sweet music. He was so curious to know everything. The boy was very interesting and disciplined. All the teachers loved him and advised him to read good books. The boy started to read books on science and nature. His interest in science grew day by day. Physics became his favorite subject. These good hobbies helped him to work hard to find new things. With his hard work, he became a famous scientist and got the Nobel Prize in 1930. Do you know who this boy was? Yes, it was Sir C.V. Raman. He invented his theory on light, popularly known as Raman effect. Okay, dear student, I introduce the new words. Hobby, an activity which someone does for pleasure. Curious, interested to know about something. Scientist, one who studies science, he is called scientist. One who studied about physics, he called physicist. One who studied mathematics, he is called mathematician. So right, invent, create something new. Okay, dear friend, let's start the story. The unit you call at Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu. Where he lived, the cute boy, he is looking very small. The small boy lived in Tiruchirappalli. Where he lived? Yes, he lived in Tiruchirappalli. How is Tiruchirappalli? It is in Tamil Nadu. Where it is? It is in Tamil Nadu. And how is it? It is very small village. Okay, next one. He was born on November 7, 1888. When he was born? November 7, 1888. Yes, he was born on November 7, 1888. He was very clever and smart. He was very wise. He was good in his studies, had good hobbies too. Because he was a cute boy, smart boy, he was a clever boy, so he was beautiful. He had lot of interesting something new. He loved to swim in the village pond too. For hours, yes, he spent his time in swimming. Right? Yes, he swam in a small pond in village. He had too many friends to play with. He had so many friends with him. They loved flying kites. What are they doing? Yes, he flying kites with his friend. All friends together and flying kites. And all are like to swimming in a small pond. And they use it to make colorful kites. Yes, how are the kites? The kites are very colorful, different color. They use the paper, different color of papers for making kites. Kites, do you know the meaning of kites? Yes, it is called in Kannada, Gaadikutta. The boy was always busy. He was very busy. He don't waste his time. He do something new. Anytime. He was very busy. Yes. What are his hobbies? His hobbies are swimming, making kites, flying, playing with his friend. Okay? And also he read textbook. So he become very good in studies also. When he had no work, he used to go for a long walk. He don't waste his time. When he was free, he don't have any work for doing, then he go for a walk. Walk, do you know walk? Yes. He go for walk. Why he is going to walk? See, Max, he loved to watch the beauty of nature. He loved nature. He loved to watch the beauty of nature. So he go for a walk for a long time. He was very curious about everything around him. Yes, he was very curious. What is him? What is he in his surrounding? ಏನಿದೆ ಅವನ ಮುಂದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಅವನಿಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಕುತೂಹಲಕಾರಿಯಾದಂತಹ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ. ಸೊ ಹಿ ಸ್ಪೆಂಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಬಿಜಿ. ವಾಟ್ ಹಿ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್? ಯಸ್, ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಹಿ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ವಾಕ್. ವೈ ಹಿ ಇಸ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ವಾಕ್? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹಿ ಲವ್ಡ್ ವಾಚಿಂಗ್ ದ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿ ಆಫ್ ನೇಚರ್. ದ ಬಾಯ್ ವೇಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡೇ. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ವೇಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡೇ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ it was the time to listen stories from his father. Yes, his father telling stories at evening. So he was very curious about it and he was waiting for the time. Many village people used to come his father to listen the stories of the Ramayana, Mahabharata and other stories. Which type of stories his father telling? Yes, his father told Ramayana stories, Mahabharata stories and other stories. All village people, some of the village who are free at evening, they all have come to listen the stories. The father also used to play on the veena and violin. Yes, he not only telling stories, he telling stories with veena and violin. He used violin, he play violin and veena when he telling stories. That means he telling stories with music. It is very pleasant. The boy enjoyed the sweet music. The boys, some of the boys, small boys, and this small boy also liked to listen music. He was so curious to know everything. The boy was very intelligent and disciplined, shistubadha bhara. All the teachers loved him and advised him to read good books. All teachers in his school, all teachers advised him to read good books. The boy started to read books on science and nature because he loved science, and also he was very interested in something new. That means he was very curious about something. He was very curious about everything. So he read only textbooks of science and nature. His interest in science grew day by day. Yes, he has lot of interest in science. Physics became his favorite subject. Which is his favorite subject? Physics.
Got Nobel Prize in 1930. The boy was
light. It is popularly known as Raman effect. That means Raman Parinama anta helibittu adena andre avara ondu siddhanta famous agide. Okay dear student, thank you.